Yo, how you doing, people? You good? I don't know why I asked you if you're good, because you can't respond. But anyway, I hope you're good. Wanted to do a video that was a kind of desert island discs kind of thing. Just pick a few of my favourite albums and explain to you why they're my favourite albums and why they would be my desert island discs. I've gone for five albums, because obviously we could go on forever, but I think five is a good number to kind of just give you an overview of my favourite shit. So without further ado, my first Desert Island disc would have to be American Idiot by Green Day. It's just because it's my favourite album. It was very, very pivotal in my growing up and a lot of my childhood and a lot of my memories, especially in my first bands, Cause for Concern, nice, and others. And I think especially with the other guys in FVK, we really shared this love for Green Day. And when American Idiot hit, it was a really significant time in rock music as a whole, because people have been saying the same thing they say quite a lot, like rock bands are dead, rock music's going out, it's all about electronic, which is surprisingly what they said just before the Beatles did their thing. But anyway, this was a time that was really exciting in music. There was lots of bands coming through like and getting really big, like Green Day, My Chemical Romance, Paramore, The Used. All these bands were achieving a lot of success, and there was a big, big buzz around rock music as a whole. It felt like there was a bit of a movement going on. And I was just exactly the right age when American Idiot came out. I think about 15 when it came out. Was it 2004? Don't quote me. I think it was 2004 American Idiot came out, or 2006. 2004? Anyway. and it was just, I was exactly the right point in my life. The stuff it was talking about was quite political, but then also very accessible in the way that I was at the right age. I was a little bit angry, and these songs were speaking to me. And the melodies were just undeniable. These songs were actual songs. They personified everything that I loved growing up, like listening to David Bowie and, but with the punkier side, like the Sex Pistols that I used to listen to. And it was just an amalgamation of all these things, and it was really, really exciting. It was also one of the first bands for a while that had really gone to town with the concept thing. Even though it might not have been overtly as much of a concept album as a lot of people know, obviously a lot of the songs chart the life of this guy, and it was just quite interesting to get into all that and sink your teeth a little bit deeper into something significant. So yeah, that album, and in my first bands we covered a lot of the songs like Holiday and American Idiot, Boulevard of Broken Dreams, and it just has a lot of good memories attached to it. So that's number one, American Idiot by Green Day. Number two, for a kind of a similar reason, has to be Drunk Enough to Dance by Bowling for Soup. Now, these guys were significant to me because it was one of the first albums I bought myself with my own money. I mean, there had been a lot of CDs knocking around the house, like, you know, Afro Man and stuff that my mum would listen to, and for some reason the South Park Chef's Chocolate Salted Balls song that I learned all the words to. Anyway, there's a lot of music lying around, but this is the first album I bought. I was a little late bloomer when it came to like really getting into music, I will admit, and hence obviously it being an album that's like that late on. But it came from a time in pop punk music that I think was much more rich with good songs, good melodies, and good bands. Having a go at any pop punk bands now, but I just don't think it's quite the same. Even though they were comedic, every single song on that album is a perfect pop song. One of my first shows was Bowling for Soup. I went to see them at UEA in Norwich. They were incredible, like all live, none of this backing track stuff that so many bands use nowadays, and they were just tight, and they sung everything and all the harmonies were completely on point, and it was, for me, it was just an eye-opening experience. I was like, these guys are so fun, they're obviously loving what they're doing, and it really appealed to me. So I remember biking around my friend Jack Ewan's garden, literally in a circle with a CD player in the middle of us, just put with Drunk Enough to Dance on, just listening to it and riding around. It was a more simple time. So yeah, number two is Drunk Enough to Dance by Bowling for Soup. Next up is a bit of a cheat, because I really like Queen. So I tried to find a CD or a collection of CDs, but a CD that had the most Queen on that I could find, and what I could find was the Platinum Collection. Which has Greatest Hits 1, 2 and 3. Little bit of a cheat, I must admit, but I love Queen. They're not the kind of band you can just take one album with you. I must say, I'm a bit guilty of not being the kind of fan that that knows every song on all the albums. I do think there's quite a lot of Queen songs that are a bit, you know, they're a silly band. But again, it came from a nicer time that bands could both have a sense of humour and write incredible songs, and people would take them seriously still, like bands like Nirvana. Now there's this overarching feeling that if you're in a band, you have to be either really serious or really stupid. There's no middle ground, which is a bit of a shame, I think. But yeah, anyway, they Queen have just been a massive influence on me. My favourite song is probably Killer Queen, just because of the way the melody bounces around and how, like, just how Freddie delivers the vocals. It's amazing. So yeah, the next one would be Queen, the Platinum Collection. Number four has to be, and I'm sure some of the other guys might put this in their collections if they do one of these videos, would have to be Chromeo, White Women. Came out in 2014. It's got a fantastic cover. Now this band are actually doing what I said previously. They are a serious, faux serious, like, funk duo. They write great music. It's really well thought out, really well structured, but they've got a sense of humour. If you look at any of their videos, they're spelt like Chrome, but EO. They just have this great time doing what they're doing, and they don't take themselves too seriously, which I find really appealing. We've been listening to basically this whole album constantly on tour. They're the songs that we use to pep ourselves up before we go on stage. And it just makes you feel good, and we like dancing. We're fiends for a bit of dancing. After loads of shows, we go out and like to dance. So Chromeo just delivers. So there you go, Chromeo, White Women. And finally, my fifth choice for Desert Island Discs. I don't know why I can't say that. Desert Island Discs. It's a bit of a tongue twister, isn't it? Yeah, my final choice has to be, and this is a tough one, there's a lot of albums I'd have liked to have put in there, but In Love and Death by The Used. I think it's one of those rare albums that every single song on it from start to finish does something for the album and is good. Like, undeniably, a lot of albums have filler, there's songs on it that you like and songs you just kind of like, meh, and songs that you love, but this album, all the songs are different. They all provide a really different tone, but every single one of them is just perfectly put together. I'm a sucker for a really, really, like, nice melody, but a bit geeky, but the drummer and bassist work amazingly well together. Bert was on top form when it comes to his vocals at that point, and I don't think they've released an album as good since, which is a shame, but maybe they'd disagree. Maybe it's just because it was at that point in my life, but it's an incredible album. They've just done their anniversary tour. I think it speaks for itself because most of the dates have been selling out. I sadly couldn't go, but I'm sure I'll get a chance to see them at another point. But yeah, it's just an album that did a lot for me when I was younger, and it holds a lot of memories, and every single one of the songs is amazing. So yeah, that's the final one. The Used, In Love and Death. Well, I guess that's it. thanks for watching my desert island discs. It's been fun. I'll get the guys to do some more of these, so hopefully we'll have some of them getting involved and telling you about their favourite albums. But for now, I'll see you soon. Cheers.